Hello students, today we will perform the physical pharmacy practical which is related with chemical kinetic. See the aim of your practical: to study the order of reaction by acid hydrolysis of methyl acetate. Acid hydrolysis of methyl acetate, that is one example of first order kinetic. So before starting the practical, first you have to know what is chemical kinetic, the different type of chemical kinetic, examples of different types of chemical kinetic. So what is order of reaction? Order of reaction is defined as the number of concentration terms on which the rate of a reaction depends when determined experimentally. So what is order of reaction? That is defined as the number of concentration terms on which the rate of reaction depends when determined experimentally. That is known as chemical kinetic. Now different types of order of reaction is there: zero order, first order, pseudo first order, like that. So all of you already in first semester you have studied about that. So what is the meaning of zero order? We know that zero order means the reaction in which the rate does not depend on the concentration terms of the reactant, concentration independent. That is known as zero order. So what is first order reaction? The first order reaction is defined as the reaction in which the rate of reaction depends on concentration of any one reactant. I am repeating, first order reaction is defined as a reaction in which the rate of reaction depends on the concentration of any one reactant. Mathematically, the first order rate equation that can be written as minus dc upon dt, which is proportional with concentration. So minus dc upon dt is proportional with c. C means concentration of any one of the reactant. So if we simplify, so we'll get minus dc upon dt is equal to k1c. What is k1? K1 is the specific rate constant for first order, and what is c? C is the concentration of reactant. Different examples are there. For example, decomposition of hydrogen peroxide catalyzed by 0.02 molar potassium iodide. That is one example of first order kinetic. Some other examples are also there. For example, acid hydrolysis of ethyl acetate and methyl acetate, or inversion of sugar, that means sucrose, disintegration of radioactive elements, all are examples of first order kinetic. So first example, that is acid hydrolysis of methyl acetate, we will perform today. So this is the theory behind this. Now in so what is the equation which is used for first order reaction, that you will get in the textbook of physical pharmaceutics by CBS Subramaniam, first chapter, that is chemical kinetic. So if you want to know the details about that, or memorize the what is chemical kinetic and the details of derivation of the first order reaction, so you can follow that chapter, derivation that has been given. So here, whatever equation today you will use, that is according to the derivations of first order reaction. So chemical that is required for this experiment, that is methyl acetate. Next is 0.5 normal hydrochloric acid, 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide. Next, phenolphthalein indicator. All are the chemicals that is required. Apparatus, that is beaker and glass apparatus, that is required for this experiment. Burette, pipette, beaker, measuring cylinder, like that. So what is the procedure behind this? First, you have to take 100 ml of 0.5 normal HCl in a conical flask. Here one point is important, that is temperature you have to fix, that is 30 degree centigrade. See that has been mentioned in first point. Take 100 ml 0.5 normal HCl in a conical flask in constant temperature water bath, and water bath the temperature is maintained, that is 30 degree centigrade. Note this temperature and maintain it throughout the experiment. Next, add 10 ml of methyl acetate to the above mentioned conical flask, which contains 100 ml 0.5 normal HCl. and note the time at addition. This is zero time. You have to consider is zero time when you are adding methyl acetate in 0.5 normal HCl. That is zero time. Next, shake the reaction mixture and immediately withdraw 5 ml from it and transfer to another one conical flask which contains some crushed ice or cold water to arrest the reaction or to cease to equilibrium. Then titrate this mixture against 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide using phenolphthalein indicator till pink color persists for at least 1 minute. Let this titrating, that is V0 ml. Next, start the reaction mixture frequently and withdraw each time 5 ml of the reaction mixture from the conical flask at 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50 minutes and titrate the reaction mixture against 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide using phenolphthalein as an indicator. So let the titer reading be VT. Note all the reading in different time intervals and mention into the observation table. Next step is take another one conical flask, take 50 ml of reaction mixtures on a boiling water bath for 1 hour. After reflux, cool the reaction mixture to the water bath temperature and withdraw 5 ml of refluxed reaction mixture and then titrate it against 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide. This is another one setup. Let the titer reading, that is V alpha. So we will get total how many readings? VT, that is total V0, V10, V20, 30, 40 and 50. So total 6 reading we will get from first conical flask. And this is another one V alpha, that is after refluxing 50 ml of reaction mixtures on a boiling water bath. So we will get total 7 readings. So next, after getting all the readings, you have to do the calculations. See that temperature of water bath that you have to maintain throughout the experiment, that is 30 degree centigrade. Second observation, that is initial concentration of reactant, that is designated as small a, that is V0 minus V alpha. So you will get one value. Burette reading, third observation, that is burette reading after refluxing the reaction mixture, that is V alpha. So you will get one reading that you have to mention here. Observation number 3. So 3 observation you will get. Temperature of water bath, initial concentration of reactant, that is small a, and burette reading after refluxing the reaction mixture, that is V alpha. See that observation table. In first column, time, every time interval, that is 10 minutes. First one is at 0 time, next 10, 20, 30, 40 and 60. So up to 60 minutes you have to take the reading. VT, every time you will get the value of VT. Next, A minus X, from where you will get this value? V alpha minus VT. So every time whatever reading you will get, that is VT, you have to subtract from V alpha. Next, you have to take the log value of A minus X. Then calculate A upon A minus X. Take log value of A upon A minus X. And K, that is absolute temperature. So calculate according to the temperature. So how to calculate that? This is important part. How to calculate? See that, how to calculate that K value? That means first order rate constant, reaction rate constant. So determination of K by substitution method and determination of K from graph. So by using these two method, we can calculate the reaction rate constant, that is K. First method, determination of K by substitution. How to do that? Substitute the burette reading in the given equation and find out the value of reaction rate constant. Very simple. From graph, how you will get? In the logarithmic form, the rate constant equation for first order, that is written as like this, log A minus X is equal to minus K upon 2.303 T plus log A. Now take one graph paper, plot the graph, that is log A minus X on y axis and T on x axis. So you will get a curve draw the best fit line, find the slope of that curve and calculate the value of k by using the equation, that is slope is equal to minus k upon 2.303. So when you will calculate the slope, so only unknown value is k, okay, or so k is equal to this one 2.303 minus 2.303 multiplied with slope value. So very easy practical. So just you have to take one conical flask and you have to take 0.5 normal HCl, maintain the temperature, that is 30 degree centigrade, zero time. You have to withdraw the sample after adding 10 ml methyl acetate. Then every 10 minutes gap, you have to withdraw the 5 ml reaction mixtures and you have to titrate against 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide using phenolphthalein indicator till pink color persists for at least 1 minute. So total you will get the 7 readings. And another one, that is reflux, 50 ml of reaction mixtures on a boiling water bath for 1 hour. After reflux, cool the reaction mixture to water bath temperature and withdraw 5 ml of reflux reaction mixture and titrate against 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide, that is V alpha. So after getting all the value, just calculate log A minus X and A upon A minus X, then log value of A upon A minus X. So after calculations, just plot the graph by taking time in x-axis and log A minus X on y-axis. Plot the graph, draw the best fit line, find the slope and calculate the value of K. And finally, report the result. The value of K is this much by substitution method and from the graph. So you will get two value by using two methods, substitution method and from the graph. So since the K value remain practically constant, the hydrolysis of methyl acetate in presence of acid follows first order reaction kinetic. That is the conclusions. Okay, I think the what is the aim of your practical and how to do that, that means procedure, I think that is clear to all. So now coming to the important questions that may ask in your synopsis or in Viva OC. See that first question, define chemical kinetic, rate of reaction, law of mass action and order of reaction. Second question, what is first order reaction? Give any one example for the same. Third one, give Arrhenius equations. I have not mentioned here Arrhenius equation, but in stability, accelerated stability study, that practical already you have performed. There I have already discussed about that, what is Arrhenius equation and what is energy of activation, how to calculate that, everything that you have already performed. So I think there will be no problem to understand what is Arrhenius equation. Number 4, give applications of reaction kinetic in pharmacy. And number 5, give the principles of chemical kinetic of acid catalyzed hydrolysis of methyl acetate. See, after seeing my video, you have to write these questions. That is, second question, what is first order reaction? Give any one example for the same. And fourth question, that give applications of reaction kinetic in pharmacy and write down the derivation of first order reaction. Okay, these three questions that you have to write. So take a pen and paper, write down these three questions as the assignment of today's practical. Write down the answers, make PDF and send it into a email ID, or I will mention my email ID. So you have to send that your answer in email ID, that particular email ID, or you may also upload it in your classroom. So it's better, I think I will make one email ID, you send it into that email ID only. I will assign today, that is A batch, so I will assign this practical only to the A batch. Okay, thank you very much.